Good morning, everyone. Thank you for your patience. Just had to sort out some technical matters. I just want to take this time to say good morning and to welcome each and every one of you joined in via Zoom and via YouTube. This morning is another Monday morning Bible lesson or teaching session, and we are grateful that you are here to study God's word with us, but also to join us in prayer. And so I just would like to invite you to bow with me at this time as we have the opening word of prayer. Loving Father, thank you so much for another morning. Thank you for your word, which is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. We pray that you will draw us closer to you as we study it. We pray that you'll be with every participant, and we thank you for our presenter and all who will minister to us this morning. Please let the Holy Spirit preside over all that is said and done, and may you be glorified through our worship. This is our prayer with thanks. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. All right, so I want to take this opportunity now to go ahead and welcome those who have joined us on YouTube. I can see that there are 15 devices connected. And to the owners of those 15 devices, I just want to say welcome. Good morning to you. And if there are any others who have also joined in from your households, on behalf of the entire Long Island District, we also say good morning and welcome to them also. On Zoom, I am seeing that we have a total of 96 devices connected. I would also like to say good morning and welcome to the owners of those 96 devices. And if there are any others tuned in from your households, on behalf of the entire Long Island District Prayer Team, I also say good morning and welcome to you. Now, at this time, as mentioned, it's Monday, and so we are going to be having our Bible study this morning. And to read our scripture text for our study will be Sister Curleen Forbes. And so I turn it over to Sister Curleen at this time.
Good morning. Now, upon the scripture lesson is taken from Luke 24:1-11. Now, upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, he came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them and shining a garment. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but he is risen. Remember how he spoke unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men from the sepulchre, and told all those things unto the 11 and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene and Joanne, and Mary, the mother of James, and other women that were with them, which told these things unto the apostles. And their words seemed to be to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. So ends the reading.
Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Curleen. At this time, we are going to have Sister Antoinette Miller Wilson introduce our presenter for this morning.
Thank you. Blessed morning, everyone. I have been given the task of introducing our guest speaker for this morning. What a privilege. Vanessa is a woman of virtue and simplicity. She's a living inspiration to everyone she meets. Affectionately called Van, she is a fourth generation Seventh-day Adventist. She is also a board certified OBGYN and is currently residing in Kemp's Bay, South Andrews with our parents, Mr. and Mrs. Charles Miller. Vanessa has traveled the world as a dedicated medical missionary, and I think that's what she wants to finally settle into, being a medical missionary. She loves her Lord, and she is constantly praying for family and friends. She wants her family and friends to remain faithful so that we can all meet together in heaven. Brothers and sisters, this morning it gives me great pleasure to introduce Vanessa as our guest speaker. Please pray for her as we all pray for each other as she speaks. Vanessa.
Amen, amen. Thank you so much, Sister Antoinette. Just as Sister Vanessa comes with the presentation, we are going to have our song, which will be sung by Sister Selena Hunter. And then the next voice that we will hear will be that of Sister Vanessa Miller. May you be blessed by this rendition.
Quickly drawing near, but as they prayed for deliverance, the victory word began. For when we call upon the Lord, we summon all of heaven. Pray on, for you are whom the Lord is looking for. Pray on. Every soul in the victory, pray on. When thine face the lions, for worship we belong. It seems there was no hope at all for what would be in store. But when we stand on holy ground, all this prayer is heard. Instead of on our circumstance, our eyes are on the Lord. Pray on, for you are whom the Lord is looking for. Pray on, for this will tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay your needs, and he hears each time you pray. Your prayers are reaching heaven, and the answers are beyond. For this will tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay on your knees, for this is where the battle is won. There's no better place for you to be than seeking Father prayerfully. Very soon you'll win the victory. Pray on. Pray on.
Good morning. And thank you all so much, Long Island District, for allowing me the opportunity to share in this Bible study this morning. Thank you, my dear sister, for your kind words of introduction. And let us invite the Holy Spirit to speak to our hearts now as we go into our study. Father, we invite your Holy Spirit to be with us, to open our hearts and our understanding. Thank you for the assurance that you will teach us and that you will also bring back to our memories what we have studied. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Our talk today is entitled Lessons on the Road to Emmaus, and it is based on the account from Matthew and Luke, inspired by my study of the spirit of prophecy, as well as some of Charles Spurgeon's work, and I pray that it will be a blessing to all of us. So let's take a moment to set the context. Let's turn to Matthew chapter 20, verse 17, where we see Jesus going up to Jerusalem and taking the 12 disciples apart and saying to them, "Behold, the Son of Man shall be betrayed unto the chief priests and scribes, and they shall condemn." And then let's skip down to verse 28. "Even as the Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister." And here's the key: "to give his life a ransom for many." So Jesus is talking about his impending death and his resurrection. But Jesus' words mean nothing to the disciples at the time that he's saying it. They think to themselves, "The Son of Man came to give his life a ransom for many? And how could it be that the Messiah could even be crucified? Doesn't the Torah say something about that being a curse?" So they couldn't believe. And this is why there was a need for the Emmaus experience. It was imperative for Christ to clarify to his disciples, in the midst of their disappointment and unbelief, that he was indeed the Messiah, the promised one, and he had conquered death just as he said he would. So let's pick up the narrative in verse 13 of Luke chapter 24. Verse 13 says, "And behold, two of them went that day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 60 furlongs. Verse 15, "And while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus drew near and went with them, but their eyes were holden that they should not know him. And he said unto them, What manner of communications are these that ye have as ye walk and are sad? And one of them said unto him, Art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem and know not the things which are come to pass there? And Jesus said unto them," in verse 19, "What things? What things?" And they said unto him concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which was a prophet, and how the chief priests and our rulers have crucified him. 23, when they found not his body, they came saying that they had also seen a vision of angels, who said that he was alive, and went to the sepulchre and found it, as the woman had said, but him they saw not. Then Jesus said unto them, O fools and slow of heart, to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all of the scriptures the things concerning himself. Here we see that Jesus is giving a Bible study on everything in the Old Testament that pointed to himself. He could easily have started at Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, and said, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. I was the creator. I am the creator. That is mentioned in Genesis 1, verse 1. And we have support for this in St. John 1, verse 1. And Jesus told his friends on the road to Emmaus that what they had learned in the synagogue in Isaiah 53 was 100% talking about him. He had vicariously suffered in obedience to the will of his Father. He had suffered in the stead of somebody else, as a substitute. Verse 10 of Isaiah 53 says, it pleased the Lord to bruise him, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. Fact is, Jesus had done nothing worthy of punishment, yet he was bruised, and this was God's sovereign will. In that all covenants at that time had to be ratified by blood. And Jesus revealed to his disciples on that walk that his death, his spilled blood on the cross, would represent a sacrifice that fulfilled the covenant between Jehovah and the children of Israel, and that his blood would cleanse them from sin. And then as they walked along, Jesus revealed to his friends how another passage foretold his suffering. It was an 8-mile walk after all, so he had lots of time to talk. Let's look at Genesis chapter 22. Genesis 22. The passage starts out like this. And it came to pass after these things. After what things? After God called Abraham and promised to make his descendants like the stars of the sky and as the sand of the seashore. After he had Ishmael and negotiated with God to save Sodom and Gomorrah, but those wicked cities were destroyed. After his son of the covenant was finally born to his wife, Sarah. After he reluctantly sent away Hagar and Ishmael. After these things, God did test Abraham and said unto him, Abraham? And he said, here I am. Verse 2, and God said, take now thy son, thine only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and offer him for a burnt offering. And Abraham rose up and took two of his young men with him, and Isaac his son, and went to the place that God had told him. Now, when the child was becoming a man, this unimaginable trial was before him. Isaac was the light of the home, the comfort of Abraham's old age. Above all, he was the inheritor of God's promised blessing. To lose this son either by accident or sickness would have been heart-rending to Abraham. But no, God commanded him to shed the blood of that prized son with his own two hands. It seemed impossible to him. That day was the longest that Abraham had ever experienced. Yet Abraham strengthened his soul by meditating on the evidences of God's goodness, his mercy, And Abraham's faith repeated to him the promise. In Isaac shall thy seed be called. Isaac. Abraham's faith repeated to him the promise.
The power that gave him life, restore it.
Abraham accounted, according to Hebrews 11:19, that God was able to raise him up even from the dead. And so, as together they climbed toward the summit, Isaac was silently wondering where, so far from the flocks, the offering was to come from. And finally he spoke up, "My father, I see the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering?" "Not yet." He could not bring himself to tell him yet. "So, my son," he said, "God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering." Then later, with trembling voice, Abraham revealed to his son God's message. Terrified and amazed, but Isaac did not resist. Now, we know that Isaac could have easily escaped if he chose. Abraham was 100 years old. He was exhausted from the struggle of those 3 days and could not have matched the strength of this strapping youth. But Isaac had been trained by his father from childhood. Spoken between them, the last tears shed, the last embrace is given, and the father lifts the knife to slay his son in obedience. But suddenly, his arm is restrained by a strong arm, and an angel of God calls out of heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." He answers, "Here am I. Lay not thine hand upon the lad, for now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me." Then Abraham saw a ram caught in a thicket, and quickly he offered it instead of his son. Jesus explained to his companions on the road to Emmaus that the ram offered in the place of Isaac represented him, the Son of God, who was to be sacrificed in our stead. Man was doomed to death for transgressing the law of God the Father. But he looked upon his son and said to the sinner, "Live, I have found a ransom for you." And as the travelers continued their tireless walk to Emmaus, Jesus explained to his companions that God had commanded Abraham to kill his son, not just to test his faith, but also to impress Abraham's mind with the reality of the gospel. All the agony that Abraham went through was permitted so that he might understand from his own experience the extent of the sacrifice made by the infinite God in giving his only beloved son for man's redemption. No other test could have caused Abraham such torture in his soul, and no other sacrifice would have made him understand God's love like giving up his own son. As Jesus shared these thoughts, Cleopas must have asked himself, what stronger proof can be given of the great compassion and love of God? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Jesus wanted to establish the faith of his disciples on the firm foundation of the reliability of Scripture. They had all along seen Jesus' death as the destruction of all their hopes. Now he showed from the Old Testament that his death was in fact the very strongest evidence for their faith in him. Now today, many professed Christians discard the Old Testament as useless, but this is not Christ's teaching.
The Savior showed that he is revealed in the Old Testament just as clearly. The miracles of Christ are a proof of his divinity. But a stronger proof that he is the world's Redeemer is found in comparing the prophecies of the Old Testament with the actual history of the New. Christ must die, as every transgressor of the law must die if he continues in sin. Returning to our story, the sun had gone down, and the disciples were about to enter their home. The stranger appeared as though he would continue his journey, but the disciples felt drawn to him. Their souls hungered to hear more from him. "Stay with us," they said. It didn't seem like he was about to accept the invitation, but they urged him. "It's getting toward evening. The day is far spent. Stay with us." Charles Spurgeon remarked that this walk to Emmaus seemed so short because it was so sweet. Those brothers walking with Jesus must have often throughout the rest of their lives looked at each other and said, "We walked with Jesus." Brothers and sisters, what a great thing it is to come near to Christ. For Jesus does not draw near to anyone for nothing. He has an impact on everyone he visits. Before Jesus passes on and leaves us to our own devices, oh, that we would cry out to him and never cease to cry till he comes and abides with us. It is his custom not to stay anywhere unless he is invited and urged to stay. But under the circumstances, he and his companions seemed very likely to part. Not because of any ill will or anger. Not because they were tired were they likely to part ways. No, if Jesus had gone on, they would have lost his delightful company through their own neglect and forgetfulness. What if in the care about the evening meal, one of them had forgotten to invite Jesus in? They could not have felt indifference towards him, but maybe they could have forgotten to urge their hospitality on him. You know, we sometimes have short memories where hospitality is concerned. Sometimes we fail to invite a friend when he needed our kindness, and then later we feel sorry about it. But if they had lost him, it would have been simply through forgetfulness. When Jesus, through his Holy Spirit, opens the scriptures to us and then opens our hearts to receive them, what a blessing it is to us. Yes, it is our happiest moment when we spend it in Jesus' company. But sometimes in the stress of our responsibilities, in the conversations with our fellow men, even in our daily chores or the work of the church, we may forget to invite Jesus to abide with us. More often than not, our communion with the Lord is broken by a lack of thought. So, brothers and sisters, let us ensure that we never forget to entertain the Savior. Let this be our first thought, that we give Jesus a lodging in our souls. Our morning prayer, "Abide with me." Our evening petition, "Abide with me." Our prayer all day long, "Abide with me." What is it under the sun, under the earth, in heaven, worthy to come between us and Christ, even for a single moment. Never let us treat our Savior as though we might leave him in a corner till a more convenient season. The disciples in the 29th verse, we find that they constrained Jesus. They didn't just invite him, but they held him. They grasped his hand and tugged at his clothes and said, "Don't go." And they would not take no for an answer. All through the Old Testament, as well as the New Testament, when Jesus reveals himself in any visible form, he has to be urged before he will abide with anyone. Remember the angel wrestling with Jacob? And Jacob said, angel said, "Let me go, for the day breaks." And Jacob responded, "I will not let you go, except you bless me." We will not have the smiles of Jesus if the smiles of the world will do just as well. If communion with worldlings will please us just as much as communion with Jesus, we will not have his company. It is only when we hunger and thirst for him, sigh and cry for him, that he will abide with us. Dear friends, I implore all of us to receive Christ even as a stranger and then come to know him as a friend. Invite him into our hearts so that he can be infinitely more to us than we can imagine. He will stick closer than a brother. He promises to teach us, but he will love us, enrich us, transform us, and then save us. So let's take Jesus in. Let him lodge with us so that we can know more and more of him. And as we break our bread to the hungry around us, in so doing, we will break it to him. Let us ever remember he is a guest worth urging, and we must do our best to humbly but earnestly detain him. And so it was that they hurry that same night all the way back to Jerusalem after Christ is revealed to them. They tell the wonderful story of the walk to Emmaus and who joined them by the way. They carry the greatest message ever given to the world, a message of joy and hope for time and for all eternity. Jesus is alive. And thank God, because he lives, our eternal salvation is secured. Amen. Good morning, and thank you all so much.
Amen.
Let us pray.
And amen. What a powerful message. We praise God for you, Sister Vanessa Miller, reminding us of that powerful message, the road to Emmaus. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, after hearing that message, we're reminded of how important it is to come to you and to hold on to you for dear life, for all our lives depend on it. We thank you so much for sending your only begotten Son to die for us. And Jesus willingly went. If Christ died for his enemies while we were yet sinners, what would he do for those that follow him, that does his word? We know that his thoughts for us are of good. And so we come. Because Jesus said, when we pray, we should go to our Heavenly Father Instead of worrying about our circumstances, like pain, sickness, bills, job, children, family, and all the other things, we're going to keep our eyes focused on Jesus, focused on the Lord, focus. Help us to remember that Jesus is alive, as was mentioned in the message, and because of that, we have eternal salvation. Father, I pray that you will cover Sister Linda and I as we pray, place your people's requests before you. These are your children whom thou lovest, whom you sent your son to die for. Hear the cries of their heart. Father, I pray that if there's any request that is not according to your will, you will show us. But Father, each request I place before you to answer it according to your will. We now move over to the requests that are on the names that are on YouTube. Heavenly Father, we place before you Dorothy Hanfield, Yvonne Adderley, Aladina Oliver, Maxine Rollins, Virginia Jarrett, Ella Marcus and Sister Vernie Spain, Barbara Wilson and her daughter, Gloria Bake, Jason Dominic, Eric and Carlota Roll, Nita Walters, Esme Seymour, Sharon Miller, Peggy Seymour, Viola D. Aubrey, Barbara Tannis, Melvern Roll, Monique Mitchell, Charmaine Ewig, Joy Khan, our friend listed at the Darples, Gwendolyn Roll, Charmaine Ewig, Olive Sterling Johnson, Ella Stafford and Kalila Ambrister and their daughter, Michelle Newman, and other participants' name who are on YouTube, whose name we're not able to see at this time. We will now go over to the Zoom names. We place before you Pastor Yon Dorset and Sister Jessica Dorset, including GJ. We also bring before you their parents, Grandma Iva, Elder Sydney, and Barbara Dorset, Ellsworth, Ianthe, Akinathan, Gabrielle, and Mariah, Elder Kelly, Veronica, Kerr, Kaylee, Omar, Tia, Nathaniel, Doran, Shauna, and Van. Bring before you Uncle Gerald, Aunt Macaline, Jeremiah, and Sarai. We place before you Sister Antoinette Miller Wilson, Carlene Forbes, Dwayne Bullins in New Mexico, Linda Gibson, Marlon, our family on AC, Adelma Roach, Elaine and Patricia Crichton, Alpheus Finlayson, Althea Charlton, Anastasia Simone, Andrew Comer, Annie Bo, Anthony Nottage, Antoinette Baptiste, Betty Hanfield de Villiers, Betty Tinker, Betty Williams, Blundell Ferguson, Boniva Brown, Elder Vespri and his wife, Carmita Ramin, Carl Brennan, Cassandra Forbe, Charlene Roll, Cheryl Bodie, Cheryl Smith, Christopher, Clarence and Charlotte Bryce, Colleen Softly, Cynthia Lightburn and Enola Daly, Darnell Johnson, David, Dion Stephen Salone, Shania, Delos Thompson, Derek Sally and Derica Bodie, Donna Hannah, Donna Roberts, Dorothy May, Sister A. Lundy Ferguson, Sister Clara McPhee, and Sister Clara, Edith Roach, Ella Oval, and Sister Maxine McDonald and Jerome, Ella Mae Macario Blyden, Elmore Jocks, Elsie Richardson, Enid Rowe, husband and son Joey, Irma Christie Craig, Christoph Karis N. Elijah, Esther Newton, Estheline Ash, Eulalie Farron, our friend Lisida and Fire Tablet, Francita Stewart, Elder Frederick Wallace, Friedman Kelly, our friend on Galaxy A30S, Jalitha Humes, Genovia Florville, Greta Kemp, and Godfrey Humes, Gwen Gibson, Helen, Pastor Jeremiah Duncan and his wife, Jackie Bull Cartwright, Kirby, Ian and Sharon Robinson, Jacqueline Langner and family, Jacqueline Brown, Janet Carey and family, Janet McDonald, Janet Patterson Curtis, Janice Johnson, Janice Coakley, Tony, Teran, Brandy, Jada, Jaden, Jennifer Moultrie, Jennifer Wilson, Joanne Lewis, Joanne Wallace, Wakan A. Lewis, Julie Davis, June Walker, Justina Knowles, Elder Karen Hepburn, Elder Kevin and Sister Sharon Robinson, Lady Olga and Don Major, Lambercy, Yasante and her family, Latonia Kelly, Lee Strawn, Elder Patrick and Sister Leonie Wilson, Pastor Leslie McMillan and his dear wife, Lester and Cindy Stewart, Lillian Rowe, Linda Maxwell and Ava Hepburn, Liz, Lorraine Leith, Lorraine Clyde Miller, Lorraine Clark and family, Loretta Charles, Lorraine Joseph, Lorraine Evans, Lucia Patterson, Lindell and Janet Rowe, Magnol T, Marcia, Mariette Ferguson, Marlin Miller, Marina Bethel and family, Marthelina Minnis, Marvis David and family, Melanie, Jason, Arthur Neek, Mo Reed, Naomi Douglas, Norma Ferguson Bell, Olga, Olive Thomas, Opal Morant, Patricia, Paula Darble, Peter and Barbara Strawn, Peter Brown, Phyllis, Portia Barnett, R. Bo, Roxanne Shea, Ruth Ramin, Ruth Walks, Sam Katrina Sam Jr., Sandra Pierre Felix, Sandra Turnquest, Sean Ray Jennings, Sharon Brown, Sharon St. Rice, Ella Sydney and Pearl Sylvester, Sister Delmar McPhee, Sister Bloomfield Clark, her three children, grandchildren, Calvin, Luvin, Calvin, and Calvante, and all her other family members, Father, replace them before you. Bring before you Sister Sonia Daly, Tamika Finley, Tamika Marshall Coley, Tanya Dames, Val Bullins, Vanessa Miller, Renita Thompson, Victorine Wallace, Ronald, Kevon, Ricky, Winsome Flowers, Demrin Brown, Sister Naomi, Sister Naomi. Also, we bring before you the Rogers household, Elder Rogers, Sister Carla, Karen, Cara, Aaron, and Cooper family, Karen, Keyshawn, and Karen, Liz, and we bring before you Elder Monker as well. We now move over to the YouTube request.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we present to you the request of Sister Hanfield. Praying for her siblings, especially hearts. Pray for Thomas Missick, who is not doing well, for the recovery of Clay, Joey, Joe, Jenkins, Lovey, Anthony, Llewellyn, and Jit Butterfield. We also pray for Charmaine, her cousins that are not feeling well, the hearts, Thomas, Clay, and we ask that you give them good health, please. We also, continuing in prayer, present Charmaine's request. We pray for her and her family, especially her mother, Zita Hansen, who is in Jamaica. Father, we also lift up Bernadette Hunter's prayer request, praying for Mrs. Alexander Prosper, her business, Donald and Janine, Lewin, Craig, Grant, Sheldon, Raymond, and Annie, and all her neighbors. Lord, we ask that you will keep them close to you. continuing in prayer for all pastors and family, all church families in the Ukraine and Russia, all equipment and programs used daily. Please comfort all the bereaved families and provide jobs for all those who have need of those jobs. Moving on to Zoom.
Yes, Heavenly Father, we place before you Sister Sharon Johnson and her family. Please be with them and fill them with your spirit. We join Sister Enid Rowe, thanking you for another day of life, grace, mercies, and blessings. We pray for Sister Roxanne Shea family, for you to convict, convert, and save and seal her family for your return. Praying especially for Caitlin, Michael Jr., Lena, Michael Sr., Jennifer, Wesley, Valentina, Osmond, Natonia, Luke, Selena, Matthias, Lucas, Roxy, Kiana, LaShawn, Nadia, Tracy, Hazel, Kelsey, Dakota, Sheila, Clara, Bonnie, Barbara, Stanley, Irene, Pinky, Rokisha, Otto, Royan, Belinda, Crystal, Tyler, the woman of the SOWC, praying for God's divine favor for Caitlin, Zoe, Alex, as they prepare to sit their BJC exams, and all the other persons sitting exams, be with them. Also, replacing Sister Roxanne's unspoken prior request before you, you know exactly what that is. She's also asking for a closer, intimate walk with you, asking you to remove anything or anyone that will hinder a relationship with you, and teach her to love you as she should, and also extends to her fellow men, asking you to use her in your service to point others to you. We place before you Sister Lee Strong's request, asking to pray for her faithful prior partners, continue to be with all our prior partners and everyone on this line. Praying for her family. We're praying for you to revive, renew, and fully convert each and every single one of us. Remembering also, help us to remember our baptismal vows by the blood and righteousness of Jesus. Actually, you intervene on the life of her daughter, Cantrell, and her sister, Dawn, and her husband, Alpheus, Sharon Russell, Cheryl Smith, so that they will be living testimonies unto God. Also, we're giving you thanks for the continued recovery of Hermine Thompson. Continue to be with him. We place before you Sister Doreen Priscilla Brown, and thank you, new God, that we were able to be blessed by Sister Colleen's reading this morning. We place before you Sister Deanne, praying for her husband, Stephen, Shania, Salone Smith, Prisca, Jermaine, Ashton, Zelda Pratt, praying for Carlton, Sands, Roosevelt, Marvin, Andy, James, Julian, Samson, Elton, Maria, and the children of the SDA Church in San Salvador, that they will be faithful to God and serve for his kingdom. We're also praying for Jackie Bo, pray for the entire family, for the Bo Dean, especially for her sister. Pray for Anita, who has been admitted to the hospital in grave condition. Be with her at this time. We're praying for Juliet, who has had surgery. And there's still many hurdles to conquer. But Father, we know that you're still in the business of healing. We've never changed. So we're asking you to touch her in a mighty way. We're praying for Rianne, Inez, and her son, who awaits a miracle. We thank you again for using Sister Vanessa Miller in such a powerful way. We thank you for the word and the reminder about the life of Christ and the importance for us to humble ourselves and to hold on to you
We place before you Sister Edith Rhodes' request, praying for herself and her family, that they will be drawn closer to you, and that we will remain faithful to you and do your bidding, that Sister Edith's siblings and their families and relatives, neighbors, friends, and all of those to be saved in the kingdom of God, for spiritual and physical healing for the sick, including those on her prayer lists, for comfort and strength for the bereaved families. Also answer her unspoken requests according to your will.
Father, we lift up prayers for Darren Marshall and family, George Marshall and family, Tabitha Molly and family, Charles Sayers and family, Gertrude Lockhart and family, Caden and Casey. Praying for healing for George, Jan, Charlene, and Sibling, and Aunt Betty, and Debbie, and pray for all court reporters. Father, we also continuing the prayer for the safe return of Sister Sharon Goodman as they return to Nassau, and we also pray for Navaja, who has serious tantrum problems. And we also lift up Sister Zemrin's prayer request for her family and her neighbors and friends, and that everyone will have a blessed day, and also for her three unspoken requests. Father, we lift up Sister Paula Darvall's request, praying for Ethan, Evan, Aiden, Adrian, Zuri, Darren, Daphne, that all will have a personal relationship with you and be saved. We pray for the sick of Johnson Park, Allison Garcia, Stanley Major, Carlton Gumby, and Jason for complete healing, and also for her unspoken requests. We also petition for Sister Johnson on special prayers on behalf today, as she is scheduled to have a laser surgery on both of her eyes today. And Lord, we pray that you will intervene, go ahead of her, guide the hands of the physician, Lord, and may it be successful. We also continuing in prayer for Sister Enid Roll, continuing in prayer for God's guidance and protection for she and her family, and for them to be drawn closer to you day by day and be led only by your Holy Spirit. We pray for salvation for her son, Joey, and all of her unsaved siblings, friends, and their families, and her unspoken requests, and healing for Siobhan Burrows, who has cancer. Continuing in prayer for Sister Joanne Lewis, praying for her family and all families, that they will have a closer walk with you and that they will stay in perfect peace and for unity, good health, and good family life. Praying for her mother, her nieces, and her nephews, Lord. And we also pray for her numerous unspoken requests. Father in heaven, we also ask that you be with all other requests that are in this chat, continuing in prayer for the children of Erna, her grandchildren, traveling mercies, and her unspoken requests. And Father, we lift up prayers for Lady Olga, for her family and friends, the Integrity Road family, the Real Harvest family, the sick and shut in, and may God always abide with us. Lord, we ask that you continue to be with all other prayer requests. We thank God for the message that you gave us through Sister Vanessa, and may God's richest blessings continue to be upon her. Praying for Nazira Miller's healing. Lord, may you grant her healing. And we also pray for Sister Justina's three unspoken requests. We also say praise the Lord. And thank God for Sister Miller's spoken message. We pray for the husband of Sister Delmar, and that God will continue to draw her family closer to you. We also continue praising God for the family of Sister Tanya Dames, her family and friends, that God will continue to bless and keep them and save them for his kingdom and for all her unspoken requests. Praying for the David family, praying for Damani and all other students to be successful in their national exams, in BGCSE art and design exams, which are today. We ask you to just go ahead of them and to help them and bring back to memory all that they've studied. We pray for the salvation, healing, deliverance, restoration for Kevon, Ronald, Junior, Kwame, Kojo, Samantha, Akeem, Lisa, Ella, Arlene, Patricia, and Victorine, Chlorine, Marcy, Ronald Sr., our families and siblings. Seal, save, convict, and convert all according to your holy will and power, O Lord, through Jesus. Amen. We also lift up prayers of Sister Delmar Matthew, praying for God's guidance over Princess Ivan Prince as they go about their daily activities today. And we pray for Brother Gibbs in hospital also. Praying for the strength in the Lord as we run this race. Lift up the family of Sister Joanne Wallace, especially Selena, Julian Jr., Issa, Ian, Sammy, Julian Sr., praying for their neighbors, Rod, Mr. Keith Bell, and family, and unspoken prayers for the youth and the success of the BGCSE exams. We pray for Latarzia Stewart. Today is her birthday, and we pray for her to be blessed. We also pray for present Sister Annie Bowles' request. We give thanks and praise for our Heavenly Father and pastor and family who is on the prayer team. We ask that you continue to be with and guide him. May he not get weary. We also lift up Sister Loretta Charles' request to convict, convert, and seal her daughter and her entire family for his coming, and also for her to have a closer walk with him and be with her unspoken requests. We will present them to you. We pray for the Gibbs family in a special way, Lord. Remember them and intervene where necessary. Father, we thank you. We also ask you for continued presence with those who hunger and thirst for God and stay close to him. And we ask you that we also be able to share and break bread with our brother and carry the message of hope around the world. We also continue in prayer for Adele Maroche's request, complete healing of the sick, especially Carmel Brown, Betsy Duvalier, Philae Francois, Elder Kurt Smith, Charles Dulcey, Craig, and Marara Sands. Remember those who are at home, members everywhere, and those of Maranatha, asking for a positive outcome to the situation of Andrew and Warren and Gail Farquharson, and Lord, for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit on the families, that we walk in the path of righteousness and answer her four unspoken requests. And Father, we ask that you continue to be with all the other spoken requests. We pray for Tehran and family, lead, guide, protect, and save them. Praying for all those who are on this prayer line also, that they may have a closer walk with you. We're continuing in prayer for the groups on prayer. Some need salvation for managers, some for love who need family, some who need to stay focused. And we also pray for the daughter of Sister Zemrine, and we pray for her brother who lost his daughter. So, Father, we ask that you will continue to be with all the other prayer requests that have been lifted, those that have not been placed in the chat. Lord, you know the hearts of everyone. We give you praise. We give you thanks. We give you glory. And we ask that you, we thank you for hearing and for answering according to your will. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just pause a little longer just to say thank you, thank you, thank you. This little prayer is for us as well as for our family. As well, we would like to thank you for waking us up this morning to see this beautiful day. As well, we would like to thank you for our health. It doesn't matter, physical health or mental health. You know, sometimes we battle with that, but thank you so much for us in our right mind. As well, we would like to thank for the prayers, the prayer requests leading out here in this study program. And Lord, as we go our separate ways, help us to keep watching and praying and share our love and compassion with others like you do with us and everyone every day. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Many thanks to each and every one of you who have led out in our study session this morning and our meeting. We want to go ahead and we want to give the Lord thanks for Sister Curleen Forbes, who did our scripture reading. We want to say thanks to Sister Antoinette Miller Wilson, who introduced her sister. Of course, we want to give thanks to Selena Hunter for that special music. And what a wonderful study on the life of Christ, as highlighted on his road with those two disciples on the road to Emmaus. So we want to give God thanks for that study by Sister Vanessa. Thank you to Sister Linda Gibson and Sister Marie for leading us in prayer. And thank you also to Brother Duane for that prayer of thanksgiving. As we prepare to end this meeting for this morning, please do not forget to reach out to Sister Olga Major to give your donation toward the building of the Real Harvest Church. Our number is 525-8056. This Thursday, we continue with the Breathe Free Stop Smoking program. Please share with your loved ones who want to break the habit. It will be on Zoom starting at 6 p.m. Thanks to those who have subscribed to the Long Island District YouTube channel. To those who have not yet subscribed, we want to encourage you to consider going to YouTube, subscribing, and if you turn on your notifications, you will never miss when we go live or when we upload a video. Let's remember also to reach out to Sister Del Rose at 454-6296 to lend our assistance and support with the prison ministry. Let's also keep that ministry in prayer. Yesterday, Pastor Williams led out in a study on mothers, highlighting Mary and her involvement in the life of Christ, even up to his death on the cross. Bible study will continue every Sunday at 6:30. You can go to the New Englishton Seventh-day Adventist channel, subscribe, turn on your notifications, and you'll never miss when they go live. Of course, you can also catch it on Zoom. Let us also remember to reach out to the members of the Grantstown Women's Ministries Department so that we can support that feminine hygiene drive, which will run until the 20th of this month. We can make donations of deodorant, soap, and sanitary pads by dropping them off at the community center or at the church annex. Of course, we can also call 425-4340 if we would like someone to pick up our donation. Also, this Thursday at 7 p.m., Sister Marie will continue with the Great Controversy reading. You are invited to join in and be a part. We're going to go into our closing hymn now. God be with you till we meet again.
God be with you till we meet again. By his counsel's guide uphold you. With his sheep securely fold you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet. Jesus be. Till we meet, till we meet. God be with you till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. Neath his wings protecting hide you. Daily manna still provide. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus. Father's feet. Till we meet, till we meet. God be with you till we meet again. God be with you till we meet again. When life's perils become found you, put his arms unfailing round you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet, till we meet. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet, till we meet. God be with you till we meet again.
Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. As we close off, we want to also give God thanks for granting Sister Latazia Stewart another year of life. May the Lord continue to bless her and guide her and grant her success and health, not only physically, but also spiritually. At this time, we're going to open up the microphones for all of those who would like to bring closing remarks. So the microphones are now open at this time.
All right, very pleasant. Good morning again. This is Val Moore. Dwayne. I'm so happy, so happy. So I believe it was last week that I was saying that I was translating, basically explaining to my friends in Spanish. So I do have the opportunity. There is a state on the side. This is it's Mexico still, but it's called Galeana. So they invited me to. They have some people there in English. So please pray for me. So we're going to study Daniel, my favorite. I think is my Bible text now. The story in Daniel. Yeah, it's very interesting. I love it. So. Guys, pray for me as I translate the best I can. I know when I pray, God is going to help me. So, estoy muy contento. Estoy muy feliz. Por favor, cuídense. So I said, please, brothers and sisters, have a good day. I'm very happy. And you enjoy the rest of your week, okay? So thank you so much. And you guys, I love you guys. And you'll have a good day.
Good morning, everyone. Give God thanks and praise for his grace and his mercies that he had extended towards us. Thank him for waking us up this morning and clothing us in a right mind. Thank God for Pastor Dusset and his entire family and the whole family of YouTube and Zoom. I just thank him for everyone, all the prayers, the songs. I thank him for the message. May God continue to bless each and everyone in a special way. May the blessings be overflowed and God continue to guide, protect, and keep each and everyone covered under the blood of Jesus. I also thank him for bringing me back safe, sound, to carry me over many gallons of water, bring me back. Thank God for all his blessings on us. And may each and everyone have a blessed and productive day to day. Everyone stay safe and stay prayerful. God bless.
Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusted in him. Good morning, my brothers and sisters on Zoom and YouTube platforms this morning, Pastor and Sister Dorset, and all of the persons on this platform, wherever you are coming from or listening from this morning. I wish you a blessed day today. I give God thanks for another day of life to be able to speak a word for him. I want to thank Sister Vanessa this morning for that word. My Lord, we need not to be getting ready. We need to be ready. It's not long now. When I came to the Hillview Seventh-day Adventist Church, Vanessa was a young girl. And to hear her this morning expound the word of God tells me that Sister Anna and Brother Charles Miller did their designed work to raise their children in the fear of the Lord. May God bless you, Sister Vanessa. Continue to speak for him. Abide with me, fast falls the one tide, the darkness deepens, Lord with me abide. When other help us fail and comfort sleep, help of the helpless, oh, abide with me. Swift to its close ebbs out life's little day. Earth's joys grow dim, its glories pass away. Change and decay in all around I see. Oh, thou who changest not, abide with me. I need thy presence every passing on. Oh, like thyself, my guide and stay can be through cloud and sunshine. All around I see, oh, thou who changest not, abide with me. I fear no foe, with thee at hand to bless. Ills have no weight, and tears no bitterness. Where is that sting? Where brave thy victory? I triumph still If thou abide with me, I triumph still. If thou abide with me, Sister Edith Roach, I'd like you to call me today, please. 392-0589. That's 392-0589. God bless all of you today. Have a wonderful day. I love you.
Good morning to everyone. Just like to wish you all a very good, productive new week. Let us stay connected to the vine. Let us stay connected because God is going to put in his appearance and we all want to make it in when he comes. Have a blessed day. Love you all. Bye-bye.
Good morning, everyone. Please pray my soul to the Lord. Have a blessed day to tell everyone in the prayer line. Let us continue praying and open that we can make it in. Pray for our call us home.
What a wonderful presentation of our Savior. What a wonderful presentation. Praise his holy name. Let us stay steadfast, abide in Christ, and follow him as he directs us to. Have a nice day, everybody. Love you all.
Good morning, everyone. Pastor Yon, Sister Jessica, the entire team, thanks so much for this powerful platform and the teaching this morning. Oh, Sister Vanessa, God is with you. Thank you for the reminder, powerful one. Let us all abide in Christ. And the message was so clear. Never saw it that way, Sister Vanessa. Thank God for using you. A happy birthday to the celebrant and to those who are mourning. I say stay close to Jesus. Abide in him. Be comforted and strengthened in your knowledge of him. I just want to say, please let us continue to join you on in the Lord, for only he can see us through to the end. Have a spirit-filled day, everyone.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Pastor and Sister Yon Dorset and the Long Island District. Thank God for the message this morning from Sister Vanessa. It teaches us how we must get ready and be ready when Christ shall come. Thank God for all those who were in this morning and listened to the message. It is a timely one, and it tells us that we should not only get ready, but we should be ready. Let us continue to pray and ask God to help us and to draw us closer and nearer to him. Thanks for the message today. May God bless us all. Amen.
Thank you, everyone, for your encouragement, your kind words, and to those who have asked for prayer, we have noted your request. We want to once again give God thanks for that wonderful reminder about abiding in Christ and desiring his presence with us, even as those two disciples did. We also want to just personally thank Brother Dwayne Bullens, Sisters Betty Williams, Naomi Monker, Delrose Thompson, Zemrine Brown, Genovia Florville, Edith Roach, and Sister Leonie Wilson for your remarks. Let's remember to pray for one another. We also thank those who have sent their messages inside the Zoom and the YouTube chats. Happy birthday once again to Sister Latazia Stewart, and may we leave from here following the example of those two disciples, desiring that the Lord would abide with us. He most certainly will, if we would constrain him, if we would cry out like Jacob, "Lord, I will not let you go until you bless me." Have a wonderful day, everyone. I'm going to leave us with this hymn, and then we will go our separate ways.
Savior.
bless me now, my Savior, I come to
Amen. Have a wonderful day, everyone.